I don't have a problem, it's just that lots of gaming headsets go through my space, and today we're gonna talk about my three favorites under $100. These three.
So it always seems like people are looking for that next best gaming headset that meets their price points and all the features that they expect. So hopefully this video is helpful. So the three contenders today are the $49 Corsair HS50. It just came out and I'm actually quite impressed with it. Then we have the $99 Classic HyperX Cloud 2 with a USB sound card. And finally, the $99 GSP300 from Sennheiser. So let me break down why these are my picks for like the best headsets under $100 right after this.
It's time to try something new with the K900M mechanical keyboard by Zalman, with Kale Brown switches, onboard macro recordings, and absolutely gorgeous RGB illumination with the white frame. Even your dog will go nuts. Check it out in the description below.
Alright, so I know the price difference is obviously present, the $49 versus the $99 pair, so let me highlight the value proposition. So the Cloud 2 offers the best value in terms of additional ear cups, so you can swap the leather ones for the velour pads that I prefer more, they are more comfortable and can breathe more too. We have a USB sound dongle that is actually decent and would deliver better sound output than most low to mid-range motherboards, and it's awesome for notebooks as well. Plus, it's the only headset that simulates surround sound because of the dongle. Now, I personally don't like surround sound because while it expands your sound environment and you feel like you're in a larger audio space, the compromise of losing the detail and the little like definition of the sound signature itself is not worth it to me. But for many who want to just experience a larger space, that's a possibility. The Corsair HS50, on the other hand, is very basic. We only get a splitter cable and no additional accessories, and I'm actually fine with that. At $50, if that's all you can spend on a gaming headset, this is a no regret option, because for $50 you get a pretty decent deal. And lastly, the GSP300 at $99 is also bare bones, no accessories, just a splitter cable included, so it's all in the product itself, and I do trust Sennheiser when it comes to audio. So first I want to cover design, and while these are all gaming oriented, the full black and stealth nature of the HS50 with the, you know, the gray logos on the side, which only are reflective, so at most times they're not even visible, this is the only pair that I would choose that I would be okay with in public, you know. And when I was choosing my very first gaming headset, I was a bit conscious too, because I'm spending money, but I don't want it to be just for gaming and I wouldn't use it outside in the public. And so the HS50 actually is the best in that regard. The Cloud 2s, because of that red and black color scheme, they're fine, and obviously they have more color options, but they do feel a little bit more gamery than the HS50. And then the GSP300 is absolutely, this is a stay-at-home only type of headset. So in terms of value, if you wanna also have a headphone for public music listening, then GSP is a no-go. The next important thing for me would be comfort and feel. And I always say that, you know, a headphone or a headset doesn't have to be full metal to feel great. Both the Cloud 2 and the HS50 have a metal frame, which is great, and some plastic pieces around. They don't creak, they're flexible, and they just feel like they can withstand some, you know, rough behavior, like throwing them around or them dropping from your desk on the floor. Everything like that is fine, and I'm confident they can withstand a little bit of roughness. The GSP300, on the other hand, is fully plastic, but it has all the same characteristics as the other two in terms of not creaking when you bend it. I can easily throw this on the floor or in my backpack, you know, moving it around, and you have that confidence that you can handle the headset with some toughness without the thing just falling apart. The HS50 does stand out a bit in terms of that it's a bit more stiff and not as flexible as the other two, but it's not a deal breaker. The GSP300 for me is the most comfortable because of the taller ear cups, thicker cushions, and also the deeper drivers. So regardless of how big your ears are, they will never make contact with the interior driver. They also expand the most to accommodate bigger heads versus the other two. Like, this thing is just massive. Look at this. Like, I'm halfway. The Cloud 2 is the second place because of the slightly softy ear cups and the really nice thick material on the middle section, so that even if your ears do make contact with the interior, it's not uncomfortable, but they don't expand as much as the other two. So right now, this is here, and I could even wear them fully extended on my head. Now, the HS50 does reveal its budget orientation because the material inside of the ear cups here is pretty thin and you can feel the plastic underneath. However, they are the most comfortable out of the three to wear around your neck. They don't feel like they're choking you or like closed in as much as the other two. And the next important thing for me would be the seal. So wearing the GSP300 and the Cloud 2 is a little bit scary at how much isolation they have when, you know, there's actual audio playing through, because I cannot hear absolutely anything in my surrounding environment. And I've missed packages, I've missed phone calls, I've missed who've come home at that point when I'm wearing these two. And so at wherever you see that as a priority for you, both provide fantastic isolation, which in my opinion, I can't have that. Yeah, I've missed too many packages. The HS50 in that regard is like a semi-open headset, and therefore you have a bit more awareness about your ambient environment. And therefore, if somebody's calling on the door, I can hear that, but still the isolation is good enough, but you get a bit more of your environment. And so I would say that's a better thing for me personally. In terms of features on the headset itself, the Cloud 2 has nothing. A little cover for a removable microphone and a non-removable braided cable. The GSP300 has an extremely satisfying smooth volume dial on the right ear cup and a mic mute when it's in the upright position, with a nice tactile bump midway through and an audible click as well, so you know when the mic is mute. And the HS50 has a volume dial that goes all the way to zero and mutes the headphone. We have a mic mute and a removable microphone with a little cover. In terms of cable noise of when the cable is brushing against your shirt, the GSP300 is the best. Next comes the HS50. Surprisingly, I'm guessing it's because the cable is not braided, but it still manages to mute it quite well. And then the Cloud 2 is the worst out of the three. I'm guessing it's because of that braiding and picks up a little bit more noise and it shoots right into the ear cup. So a little bit disappointed here.
In terms of the microphone quality, the GSP300 is by far the best out of the three. It has the most natural pickup, very good bass in the voice as well. It's not nasally and it's not as compressed. And in terms of noise compression of the background, you can still hear things, but it's kind of muted. The next mic is the HS50. I think this one sounds pretty good for $50. It's not as natural, doesn't have as good of a bass pickup. It's more harsh on the vocals, but as long as the teammates can hear you, and in terms of the volume and the sensitivity, it's great. If you're speaking too loudly, you can just simply reposition the microphone a little bit further away from you. HS50 sounds pretty good. And now the Cloud 2s, the legendary Cloud 2s. Now you can hear it sounds different, right? Because it's plugged into its own USB sound card that automatically applies noise cancellation to the microphone. And because of that, it introduces a little bit like this nasally distortion sound, which I don't like, and I actually prefer the microphone quality on the HS50 and the GSP300.
In terms of the sound signature, I prefer the GSP300 because they have the tightest bass. They have very nice and smooth roll off on the high end, so it's not super sharp. And I mean, they are all closed design headsets, but these have the largest soundstage and offer the best directional cues. So you have a better sense of how large the audio environment is, therefore making them really ideal for any gaming situation. The Cloud 2s are the most closed off out of the three pairs, but because of that sound dongle, you can widen the soundstage with 3.1 surround sound. They are the brightest out of the three pairs, so the treble is quite harsh sometimes, but it's actually very good for competitive gameplay because you can really distinctly hear those audio cues and little footsteps and little things to make you aware of your surroundings, and they have very weak bass. And by weak, I mean you don't exactly feel the bass. You can hear the bass, it's still there in like really punchy and bassy songs, but in gaming environment, you might not. Now the HS50 surprisingly have a larger soundstage compared to the Clouds 2 in stereo, making them ideal for open world games and stuff like that. In terms of the higher end, it's nicely balanced and smooth. It's not as detailed and emphasized as on the Clouds 2, but the bass here is definitely more pumped. It's like in the middle between the GSP300 and the Clouds 2. So I would call them a fun headset and very impressed at $49.
Experience every pixel with the GeForce GTX 1080 Ti and enjoy these awesome new games in full 4K resolution at over 60 frames per second, and get Destiny 2 for free for a limited time. Full details in the description below.
All right, so for the conclusion, I think the GSP300 would be like my best $99 headset pick because the microphone is fantastic, the isolation is awesome, the sound signature is superior versus the other two. Comfort-wise, it's great, and just, it's an awesome experience all around. The HS50 is a fantastic value with great build, powerful sound. You know, I've never received a complaint from my teammates when using this headset in competitive gaming, because they all just want to hear you. I wouldn't use this for streaming, but for in-game volume and in-game chat quality, it's totally passable. And the HyperX Cloud 2 is like a classic with great accessories, multiple color options, nice build quality, nice sound, and it's all in like one contained unit, all thanks to that USB sound dongle. And so these are my picks for the best gaming headsets under $100, you know, going from a really value budget orientation to something that has a bit more value added if you're into that, versus like pure performance, which I appreciate with the GSP300. So let me know if you agree, and what are you gaming on? Let me know in the comments below. Make sure to check out this other relevant content, and we'll see you in the next video.